Hey YouTube, what's up? This is Ben from the Be A Photographer channel, and in this video we're going to be going over the Levels tool in Capture One Pro 20 and how you can brighten your images, add contrast, and ultimately do a color grade using just levels. I also have another example here with a car where you can see there's not a lot of contrast in the initial image, and then we have this natural light headshot, and you'll see how levels can be used on any of these to add contrast and then do a simple, nice color grade. So let's start with this image of the car, and I'll explain how to understand the Levels tool. As you can see, in Levels you have your histogram going from your shadows on the left, your mid-tone brightness in the middle, and your highlights on the right. Basically what you're doing when you move these sliders around is changing the constraints of the histogram. Think about it this way. Your image has a large gradient going from black all the way to white with a lot of different shades of gray in the middle. If we decided that, you know what, you should make everything that's this tone of gray actually black, and we do that by sliding the bottom left over, you'll see that now we're going to have a lot more things fall into the black. If I went way too far on this, you can see now anything that was slightly gray and dark is now becoming black. And if I slide to the left, you'll see that all those details come back. So this is an easy way to add contrast. If you wanted the blacks to go a little bit darker, you can push the area for where the black point begins, and now you can see that some areas, like the wheel right here, become full black, and this adds some contrast to your image. Now on the opposite side, if you wanted your brights to be even brighter, you can grab the bottom right, and you can move this, and now you'll see that this will blow out some of the white areas. For instance, up here, you lose the detail, so you can use this just slightly if you want to bring the brightness up, because that says, oh, the point of ultimate white is no longer at 255, it's actually at 239, or whatever you set that number to by sliding on the adjustments. You can also adjust the top, which kind of does the opposite. So if you were to grab the top left here, this is for your shadows, and you drag it to the right, this will bring the shadows up. So you can see that now all the shadows are coming up, and we're losing contrast as we do that. If we were to slide on the right side, you can see that now your whites are actually going to become a lot darker, and we're getting more detail back in the sky. So let me reset this and we'll do a quick edit. Also, just a side note, you can use the automatic adjustment here to get you a good starting point, and you can always mess around from there. So let's say we wanted the bright points to be a little bit brighter, and I can just slide this over here. We want the midpoint to be a little bit darker, so we're going to slide it to the right. And that's adding some contrast there. If we wanted it brighter, we simply slide to the left, and you can see it's making everything in the middle brighter. And then if we wanted to add a little bit more contrast again, we just grab the shadows and bring the black point down. And now you can see if we hold Alt and Option on this reset, there was our original image, not much contrast. And using just levels, we added a ton of contrast and flavor to the image. And I'd say that looks much better already. Let's practice with a studio shot. Here I have this photo of Nathan. You can see I'm going to hit reset. And there is our original image. Now again, I'm just going to start by hitting the magic wand tool here, and you'll see that it brightened up a lot of our image by dragging the bottom right up and to the left. So you can see now it brought us over here, because if we look at the histogram, all the detail is here in the darks. So that means I'm bringing my white point over there. And if we go too far, you'll see we're starting to blow out and clip the skin tones here. So what I want to do is make sure I don't go past that. And right about there is pretty good. Already, if we take a look, we can see we brightened the image a fair amount, and then we can add a little bit of contrast back if we wanted to, or if we want to boost the shadows even more, we can slide the top left. So I'm going to place it right about here, and you can see there was our before, there's our after. So we adjusted the brightness, and I'm going to tone it down, and there we go. Now what we can do is control the color channels individually. Let's say I want to go into the reds, and I want to add more red into the shadows. So what I can do is grab the top here, and as I slide to the right, that's going to add more red in the shadows. If I want to add the opposite of red, which is kind of a cyan tone, we can slide the shadows to the right, and you'll see we get this kind of vintage green and blue type of effect. So if I want to do that, I could add as strongly as I wanted to, going all the way into the midtones and highlights now, or I could just add a tiny, tiny bit of it here, and I'm going to do so like that. Again, if we want to change it for the midtones, we can slide to the left to add more red into the midtones, or we can slide to the right to add more of that cyan color. And you can just play with this and you'll start getting a feel for the levels. So there we go. And then if we want to do it in the highlights as well, we can move that so you can see his skin, which is the highlight area of this image, is becoming more red and pink. Or we can slide it back and then move it, make it more green here. So I'm going to tone this down just a little bit so we can mess with the other colors as well. Now let's go into the blues, and you can see again for the midpoint, we can grab the blues and make it more purple and blue by sliding the mids to the left, or we can go to the right and that will add green, which is kind of the opposite of that blue, right? So I'm just going to double tap and that will reset. In the bottom left, we can grab to add blues to the shadow. So if we want to add the blues, we would do it on the top. And you can see this is adding blues in the shadow. If we wanted to reduce the blues or add the opposite in the shadows, we would slide to the right. And that's adding more of a yellow slash green color. And now if we take a look at the before and the after, you can see we brightened the image, we added contrast, and we also gave it that greenish blue film look. And it now has a nice vintage vibe. So that is a quick walkthrough of the Levels tool in Capture One Pro 20. I hope you learned something from this tutorial. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. And if you want to practice right now, go take a photo of something random in your house, turn it to black and white, and then move the sliders around so you can see exactly which colors get added and removed from what parts of the image using the level sliders in Capture One Pro 20. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Peace.